money. This says Russia, the money is spending, okay? But spending is mobilized by the lowest interest rate and the highest yield, right? And money is, and spending is getting into the economy, money is flowing into the economy as spending in the savings regions, okay? Savings and the investment regions, right? So we have got one fine relationship which is now clustered together. Therefore, M, the money, let's forget about the micro money now. M is the money, is a function, a certain function, or all the other money. Savings, the yield relative to the interest rate, savings relative to the interest rate. Right? So if this is a correct signs of this position are maintained, then money will be transmitted. Okay? This is the monetary transmission. It goes into the economy. Okay? And then when it goes into the economy, it affects all the liabilities. Then once the value loses effects the savings, relative to interest, okay? And so what has happened once the money has flown into the economy, a second learning process then is that the savings relative to investment is trying to respond. See, this response is that I have been affected, F divided by I is that my status has been rightly, correctly affected by the flow of money. So, S divided by I is another function of what? Of money. See, you observe that. Of money taking the place of savings and divided by that investment. Of the relative rate of return and what is the most handy real output. Another one of them would say, I have been observed positively, correctly, appropriately. Okay? This is the output, right? And the real output would say, the inner function of the effects of money, of the effects of the relative rate, of the effects of savings in particular forms. So you've got a circular motion going on. Each one is hearing the other. This is the first of the world of money, saving, interest, spending, relationship. Okay. And we take this kind of argumentation and put it in the form of an empirical model. Okay. And the process is learning. Okay. This is the idea of learning. Okay. Now, if you go to the receipt, the rushes, which are out there, then of course somewhere some of the value will become exogenous, have no relationship with the other value. As for instance, the relative R divided by I. The relative R divided by I has no different thing, has no relationship with money. It is independently generated because R itself is determined by the time rate features, by the central bank. So you will find some of this relationship will crack, will break away. Okay? These kinds of values are such as exogenous, right? And value in that system, value has no place. Because the value itself is something you can use from outside. You can't the system to behave that. It's not something that is done by the system itself. It is self-regulated, as Paul Krugman says, you know, a self-governing economy. Self-regulated. This self-regulation is endogenous. That is learning. And the whole system becomes interrelated. Now you have got a multi-value system, and you have developed a learning system by inducing this kind of what is called circular correlation behavior between the values. And then you bring, of course, tomorrow we will talk about this, but this is what we're supposed to do. It doesn't end there, it's a huge thing.